Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel Electronics. Today we will discuss about full-wave rectifier. In earlier video, we discussed about off-wave rectifier. A off-wave rectifier allows only positive off cycles and blocks negative off cycles of input AC voltage. Because of this, the average value is very low, that is Vm by pi. We can improve this average value by using a full-wave rectifier. In full-wave rectification, DC output will appear for both off cycles of input AC voltage. Therefore, the output frequency is doubled of its input frequency. For example, if input frequency is 50 Hz, then output frequency will be 100 Hz. So the average value also becomes doubled compared to off-wave rectifier. Now it is 2 Vm by pi. There are two types of circuits are used for full wave rectification. First one, center tap full wave rectifier circuit. Second one, full wave bridge rectifier circuit. In this video, we discuss first one, center tapped full wave rectifier. Here we use a center tap step up transformer with winding ratio of 1:2. Center tapped secondary winding means an additional wire connected to the exact midpoint of the secondary winding. This type of construction divides secondary voltage into two equal and opposite voltages. The voltage at the tapped midpoint is zero. Here, because of 1:2 winding ratio, we get two times of input voltage at secondary winding. So the two times Vin voltage will get divided into two parts with respect to center and other sides of the winding. Hence we get Vin at each part. The circuit diagram of full wave rectifier consists two diodes, let's say D1 and D2. Their anode terminals are connected to the two ends of the secondary winding of transformer. Their cathode terminals are joined together. This will connected to load resistor RL. The center tap of the transformer and the load resistor RL's other terminal are connected to zero potential or ground. So we can say that these terminals are connected together. We will get output voltage across load resistor RL. Let's understand the working of this circuit. So, whenever we apply AC input to this circuit, during positive off cycle, upper end of the secondary winding becomes positive and the other end becomes negative. This makes diode D1 forward biased and diode D2 reverse biased. Therefore, D1 conducts while diode D2 acts as an open circuit. So the conventional current flows through diode D1. Hence, upper half's input voltage appear across load resistor RL through diode D1. Similarly, during negative off cycle of input AC signal, lower end of the secondary winding becomes positive while upper end becomes negative. This makes diode D2 forward biased and diode D1 reverse biased. Therefore, D2 conducts while diode D1 acts as an open circuit. So the conventional current flows through diode D2. Hence, lower half's input voltage appears across load resistor RL through diode D2. So it may be observed that current flowing through the load resistor RL is in the same direction for both off cycles of input AC voltage. For the negative off cycles input also, we are getting positive output waveform. Now, if we combine positive and negative off cycles flowing through diodes D1 and D2, output DC waveform will appear like this. In full wave rectification, we are getting output waveform for both off cycles. Hence, the average value is more or exactly doubled compared to off wave rectifier. So, the average value of the full wave rectifier is given by expression 2Vm divided by pi or 0.636 multiplied with Vm. Till now, we have assumed that These two diodes, D1 and D2, are ideal diodes. But in general, these diodes have forward voltage drop across them. For example, silicon diodes, it is 0.7 volts. So our output voltage is somewhat less than input voltage. So if we observe the output voltage due to forward voltage drop across each diode, the diode will conduct only when the input voltage crosses threshold voltage. So the peak value Vm will also get reduced. Now it is Vm minus Vt. Hence the average value will also get reduced. Now average value, instead of 2 Vm by pi, it can be expressed as 2 Vm minus threshold voltage Vt divided by pi. And one more thing is that output waveform's time period is also gets reduced. Here we can express new time period as t dash, 2t dash and etc. Where t dash equals to t by 2. Next parameter, peak inverse voltage. The PIV rating of diode must be considered before designing rectifier circuit. It is the maximum voltage across a diode when it is reverse biased. For example, whenever the diode D1 is conducting, the diode D2 acts as an open circuit. Since diode D2 is reverse biased, the reverse voltage across diode D2, let's say VD2, which equals to sum of the transformer lower secondary voltage Vin and the voltage across load resistor RL, that is Vout. So reverse voltage VD2 equals to Vout plus Vin. If diode D1 is an ideal diode, then Vout is nothing but Vin. Therefore, we can write VD2 equals to 2 Vin. Suppose peak voltage of input signal is Vm, then peak inverse voltage of diode D2 equals to 2 Vm. For example, if input AC signal's peak voltage is 10 volts, then PIV rating of the diode must be greater than 20 volts. If we observe the full wave rectifier's output voltage, it is not a pure DC voltage. It is pulsating DC voltage because there is still some periodic variations in the output waveform. These variations are known as ripple voltage or AC variations in DC output. This ripple voltage can be reduced by using filter circuit at rectifier output. Just by connecting a filter circuit or a capacitor as a filter at the output, we can smooth out the ripples in the DC output. Now let's understand how this filter circuit works. Just assume that these two diodes D1 and D2 are ideal diodes. Initially, this capacitor is uncharged. During the positive off cycle, this diode D1 conducts and D2 is off. So through diode D1, the capacitor starts charging up to the input voltage reaches its peak value. At this time, the charge across the capacitor Vc equals to Vm and output across load resistor RL is also Vm. After input voltage reaches to its maximum, it begins to decrease. At this time, the voltage across capacitor Vc is greater than input voltage. Because of this, the voltage at the cathode of diode D1 exceeds its anode voltage. Due to this, diode D1 also gets reverse biased and becomes off. Now the charge across the capacitor will get discharged through load resistor RL. So our output waveform appears like this. The capacitor keeps on discharging during the negative off cycle of input signal until the capacitor charge Vc equals to input voltage Vin. When input off cycle peak arrives, the diode D2 starts conducting and recharges the capacitor to the peak value Vm. And again output voltage equals to peak voltage Vm. As soon as input voltage is less than Vm, diode D2 becomes reverse biased due to voltage stored in the capacitor is more than input voltage and diode D2 switches off. So the charge in the capacitor will get discharged through load resistor RL. So output waveform appears like this. The capacitor keeps on discharging until the charge in the capacitor Vc equals to Vin. Like this, we can reduce the ripples in the output. Now, if we analyze the input and output waveforms, the slopes in the output shows discharging of the filter capacitor and the peak shows charging of the capacitor. So, in the circuit, how well the ripple is removed is depends on the RC time constant of the filter circuit. So, for better rejection of these ripples, the RC time constant must be much larger than this time period T dash. If the RC time constant is less than the time period T dash, then the capacitor will discharge quickly and this increases the ripples in the output waveform. To avoid this, we should check RC time constant of the filter circuit. But still, if we notice, there is some ripples in the output waveform. And this voltage is known as peak-to-peak ripple. This peak-to-peak ripple can be given by expression Vm divided by 2f times RL times C, where f is the frequency of input signal. As we know, full wave rectifier output frequency double of its input frequency. So this 2f can be replaced by this frequency f dash. Suppose if you want to find the DC voltage in this waveform, then VDC can be given by the expression Vm minus peak to peak ripple divided by 2. That means here the DC voltage will be the subtraction of this Vm minus half of this peak to peak ripple voltage. That will be the approximate DC voltage of this waveform. So this will be the expression of DC voltage after the filtration. Suppose if this ripple voltage is much less than peak amplitude of the sine wave, in that case the approximate value of DC voltage will be equals to Vm. This ripple voltage can also be expressed in terms of load current, that is IDC divided by 2f times C. How well this ripple in the output can be removed is defined by the parameter which is known as ripple factor. The smaller the ripple in the output, the more effective is the rectifier. Ripple factor is defined as the ratio of the RMS value of AC component to the DC component in the rectifier output. For full wave rectifier without any filter circuit, ripple factor is equal to 0.48, while in off wave rectifier it is about 1.21. So ripple factor can be improved by using full wave rectifier. It can be further increased by using filter circuit. For full wave rectifier with filter circuit, the ripple factor can be given by this expression. Next parameter, efficiency. Efficiency defines how well AC power is converted into DC output power. The efficiency of full wave rectifier is 81.2%. Recall off wave rectifier's efficiency, that is 40.6%. Therefore, a full wave rectifier is twice effective than a off wave rectifier. Here I have summarized different parameters which we have discussed for full wave rectifier. Some parameters we have discussed very briefly. We will derive all expressions in another video. This table showing comparison between off wave rectifier, center tapped full wave rectifier and full wave bridge rectifier's parameter value. Please go through this comparison chart. That's all about full wave rectifier. If you have learned from this video, please do mention them in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please click the like button. Help others to learn by sharing this video. Please subscribe and turn on notifications for more such videos. Have a nice day.